And look at him glowing. Look at that glow.
Because, like, my enemies, they are trying it. My village people, they are trying it. They really are trying.
This is one thing I hate about staying in this country, in Nigeria. Like,
Amina, say hi. See money.
But then it hit me that this is the first Friday in the month of June. This is the first Friday of Pride. How the fuck am I going to be indoors?
Hey guys, what is good, what is popping? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It is your favorite boy, Vikwanda, right here in the building. And today I am bringing you guys another vlog. So we're going to be doing another week in the life. I know I did one recently, but I am in Lagos, as some of you may know. And I want to show you guys what I did for my first week arriving in Lagos. Everything I had to do, everywhere I had to go. I vlogged everything for you guys because you all know I'm a generous queen like that. Yes, but before we dive into it, don't forget to like and subscribe. You all know how we do it on here. Don't forget to show some support. Hit the like button, hit that subscribe button. And without further ado, let's get into it.
So glad. So, you're so lucky that he has this good thing about. You are ready on fast, right? The way I just say I don't say it. I know I'm always like trying my best to be like, yeah, do you get like very, because I know that performing is a struggle. Do you get one out of the
this though? Is it like when I came to talk to you?
But like, I love when I played it for Spartans.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that is, you know, yesterday, right?
No, no, the first. I think the first.
Yeah, that's, so now that I played for Spartans, so that's it. Like, well, lucky you, because. Your God saved you, God. You might have blocked.
What is that?
So in case you're wondering what you're watching, you're just seeing two homosexuals gossiping, kicking, talking, and basically catching up. So this is my friend Kayode. He's the one hosting me here in Lagos. Amazing human being, a comrade in arms. So for my first day in Lagos, we actually went out. We went to Sweet Sensation initially. And then we went to the mall, we picked up a couple of things, and we got back home, ate, we're just here kicking, just catching up basically.
Or should we use this, your bookshelf as background?
Yeah.
So, I'll turn the ring light.
Okay. Oh. Is it okay? The key from the back?
Yeah, it is. Put your legs a little closer. Alright guys, I'm escorting my friend to the airport. He's leaving the country and this is what I'm going to start the day with. A trip to the airport. So let me just quickly wear something nice. Not really something nice. Let me not steal your thunder, Kayode.
Earrings, throw in my cleaner for my nose piercing, throw in my hairspray, throw in a bath gel, throw in, yeah, toothbrush,
prep. How about toothbrush?
Toothbrush or toothpaste, prep. No.
They're not ready.
They're not ready. Like, I
they're not ready. You forgot that that is like additional slay.
What else?
I know.
That's all. Bring your other key.
Alright guys, off to the airport.
So guys, we are at the airport and look at him glowing. Look at that glow. Hey God. Montego, we actually arrived at least before one.
Yeah.
So nothing just going on, still just start checking it. Have your vaccine yellow card?
No.
It's an international flight. You forgot.
What the fuck is a vaccine yellow card?
Like your COVID-19 vaccine card.
Oh.
Have you been vaccinated?
Yes, I have.
But they did not give you the card.
They didn't give you the card.
I have the card. I didn't know.
You don't bring it. You cannot travel without bringing your card.
Oh my God, guys! Like we are literally in like at a crossroads right now. Do you know even me? I brought mine from Enugu down here. Like, I did not know. I forgot.
I totally missed your bags.
Especially for international.
Oh, shit.
So guys, Kaede has traveled. I'm back home. I've been back home for like 2 hours now. And out of those 2 hours, I ordered food, right? An hour ago. This food has literally decided not to come. I've actually heard about this delay with Jumia food that happens in Lagos. But like, I did not expect it to happen to me this early. Like, I literally just came into Lagos a couple of days back. I ordered food like an hour ago. I am so hungry. I've had just one meal today. And I'm still waiting for the food. I don't even know if I should go and make noodles now. And the crazy thing is that you cannot even cancel the order. So like, even if I go make food now, the order will still come. Right? I'm just tired. Today has been stressful. Let me even give you guys like the tea on what eventually happened with Kaede's flight. So first and foremost, we got to the airport a little bit late and they had already stopped checking in. Secondly, Kaede forgot his COVID-19 vaccine card. And lastly, because he had like rescheduled his flight before, they said that this new ticket was not booked properly, that the extra amount of money he was supposed to pay for rescheduling, he did not pay. So that was like another whole crazy ass issue. So we had to stay there and reschedule again for the evening. You know, his flight was supposed to be for 1:40, so we had to reschedule for 8 p.m. And I had to wait there with him at the airport up until 5 p.m. when they started checking in. And then I came back home. And I came back home, I tried to get food, I tried to order food. Everything is in the mud, everything is in shambles. I have not seen my food, nothing. I'm just exhausted, honestly. I just cannot wait to have something in my stomach and just go to bed. So I just spoke with their customer care. I just chatted Jumia customer care and they told me that they cancelled my order due to logistic reasons. and y'all do not send me any message. I've been waiting here for the past 1 hour. Guys, I'm going out now to go and look for something to eat. This is just fucked up. Good morning, welcome to another day of my first week here in Lagos. Let me just tell you guys, right, yesterday my enemies tried it. I had such a bad day, started from the airport where we had to wait for hours, you know, for carriages, rescheduled flight, and then I came back home, ordered food. You guys saw what happened. I couldn't get the food, it was cancelled. I was waiting here, they didn't even tell me that they had cancelled my order. But the worst of all that happened last night is my phone screen breaking, literally shattering. So when I was trying to film that my dinner, when I was eating, my phone fell down. And this is why I've been saving up money to buy a camera so I don't have to keep using my phone to film, and I cannot afford a camera yet. Like, my phone has literally broken. Like, let me show you. This is the screen guard, or this was the screen guard. Can you guys see? And my phone screen almost looks like this now. Can you guys see this? My phone screen almost looks like this, and it's so depressing. I've just been having a bad time since I came to Lagos. It's so depressing. Where do I see money to go and fix my phone screen? Like, where? I have so many other expenses right now. Anyways, like, nothing is going to bring down my energy. Nothing is going to bring down my the spirit of pride, because, like, my enemies, they are trying it. My village people, they are trying it. They really are trying me. To uplift my spirits this morning, I went and got a meal that I've not had in forever. I don't think I've had agoyin in the past 3 years. So the last time I was in Lagos was last year, March of last year, and I actually did not eat agoyin. And before March of last year, I had just come out to my family, so I had left Lagos for about a year and a couple of months. So just add all the time I have been away from this state, I have not had agoyin. So agoyin is basically beans, right, but like a little mashed, and then there's this particular stew that they use that is not the regular stew. Let me show you guys. So this is what it looks like. Can you guys see that? So, and I'm having it, I'm pairing it with bread here. So guys, let's talk about something. We entered Pride Month, the queer community in Nigeria. We entered Pride Month, this month of June, on a very sad note. Really, really sad. So there's this young boy, a queer boy, that shoots porn, that films porn. And one thing that people in the porn industry, especially the queer porn industry in Nigeria, do, is they cover their faces with masks when they shoot or record porn. Especially because of, you know, the homophobic climate, all of the discriminatory laws against the queer community. So they don't show their faces. All of these porn creators don't show their faces in the porn. But this particular boy, who goes by the name Kachi, he shows his face in porn. Like, his own brand is Maskless Porn or something like that, right? And the people he collaborates with, or most of the people he collaborates with in these videos, don't also wear masks. So recently he was ketoed. Now, if you've been following me for a while, you know what the term keto means. It's basically when a queer person is set up and, you know, catfished by a straight person, a straight homophobic person or straight homophobic people, and they set him up, they set traps for him, And when he falls into their trap, they exposed him to a mob, and the mob dealt with him. Trigger warning, I'm about to put a picture on my screen that is wildly, wildly gory. I'm so sorry for those of you that might be triggered. So this picture you're seeing is a picture of his back. This was what the mob slash the police did to this boy. Because after the mob were done with him, they took him to the police for being queer. Like, this, they did this to this child for being queer. This boy did not steal. This boy did not kill anybody. They dehumanized him, made him walk down the streets naked, completely naked. Now he's in the custody of the police, and I've just spoken to someone who is like trying to get him out of the police station, and they are actually asking for 3 million naira. That is the information I have right now. The police is currently asking for 3 million naira. That is not bail money because he has not been charged with anything. And these people who are currently trying to get him out of that police station, they are trying to, they want to pay the 3 million naira because they don't want the police to charge him. That 3 million, I'm going to say it here, is bribe. Bribe money. The police are threatening to charge him for homosexuality. You know, to charge him with the SSMPA. And they are saying if they don't want, if these people don't want him to be charged, if his friends don't want him to be charged, they should bring out 3 million naira. What have we done in this country as queer people to deserve this? And this boy, with all of these injuries, is not in the hospital. He's in the police station. He's in the cell with this kind of, with this kind of fatally looking injuries. This boy is in a cell and not in a hospital. And they are still charging, they are still asking for a bribe of 3 million naira.
Anyways, after I finished eating, I decided to take a short nap. And when I woke up, I started working. So I'm just responding to some emails, planning some content, and also editing my previous vlog. For those of you who have not seen it, after this vlog, go check out my previous vlog. Yes, I was editing that at this point.
So guys, I am so hungry. And I've decided to make noodles. I was going to order food, but then I thought about what happened yesterday and I got pissed all over again. Also, I'm trying to conserve money. I bought like half carton of Indomie noodles. I'm trying to conserve money because this Lagos, if you just step outside like this, they are totally billing you. Just step outside, money has disappeared. So I'm trying to save. I don't think this boy has matches or lighter because he doesn't cook at all. Kayade doesn't cook. Kayade does not cook. So I doubt this boy even has matches. This boy doesn't have matches in his house. Hunger is going to kill me. Now I have to go downstairs and get matches. This is one thing I hate about staying in this country, Nigeria. Like, I can't be like this inside my house and go out like this. I have to wear something that will not attract attention and attract curses to myself. See, like, you guys don't know the mental toll it takes to assume another personality when you're outside of your house. I don't think a lot of people understand. Like, give us queer liberation because I'm tired. Like, I'm really, really tired of this country. Mentally, it takes everything from you, honestly. Like, I have to perform right now. Not necessarily perform. Personally, I don't perform. Although, like, a lot of people have to perform and I feel for them, but personally, I don't perform. It's just that there are some lines you can't just cross. If I go out like this, like with those shorts and this, I probably would be maimed on the street. I probably would face a very angry mob. And like, it don't make no sense. Like, it just does not. It doesn't. Let me go and buy matches because Karadi does not have matches in his house. So guys, I've got some matches. Oh my god.
Okay, so I wanted to tell you guys that for those of you who noticed, I'm not on TikTok, or I've not been on TikTok for the past couple of days. I was literally banned. Again, another social media site has mistaken me for a bigot. Again, I have been mistaken for a homophobe, right? So I posted this video. I'm gonna show you guys the video I posted on TikTok. And I was given a 1 week ban for this.
Nobody gives a fuck. Nobody gives. I'm sorry. It sounds harsh, but to be quite honest with you, nobody gives a fuck.
You know, and it makes me wonder, should we really be leaving the control of these sites to bots and algorithm alone? Because these things are literally mistaking the oppressed, the marginalized, the underrepresented. They are mistaking us for the oppressors and for the bigots. Time and again, literally, YouTube, this app I'm posting this right now, took down my account, took down this channel. You guys remember, like those of you who remember that vlog, they took down my channel because they had mistaken me for a bigot, a homophobe. You know, like, you guys should go back, human beings should go back to being the ones who actually control this website and this, you know, social media platforms, because at this point I'm tired. So guys, after eating, I called Kayode and I asked him why he didn't have matches in his house. And Kayode literally told me that gas doesn't need matches, that he just turned the igniter and it comes up. Poverty has ruined me, guys. Poverty has washed me outside. So guys, the last activity for today will be me attending a party. I haven't partied in like 6 months. Like, this is my first party in so long, and also my first party of Pride. So bitch, we are going all out. We are going all out. No restraints, no holdbacks. I'm so excited. Let's get into it. This is my final look for the party. I told you guys I was gonna go out later tonight. And actually, the two friends I contacted here in Lagos to ask if they were free tonight, both of them kind of said they weren't free. So I'm going out alone, and I don't mind actually. Like, I've been doing this alone thing for a long time. I'm going to this party. It's not a queer party. When they told me that they wouldn't be able to like make it tonight, I actually got discouraged and I just lay on the couch. I was editing a particular video, but then it hit me that this is the first Friday in the month of June. This is the first Friday of Pride. How the fuck am I going to be indoors? And so I throw on a very cute outfit and I'm heading out now. The car I ordered is on the way. So let me just quickly show you guys like accessorization. So I have like 5 rings on. As you can see, I have like these 5 rings on. I have my bracelet, I have my neck piece, I have a dropping earring here and 2 stud earrings. And my hair is kind of like back to the back. Let me show you guys the full fit.
Hey guys, so as y'all can see, I have been raving, I've been partying. Child, I needed this in my life. I really, really needed this. I just came out for some fresh air. You can see I'm sweating like. So guys, that is my full fit and I look bomb. I've been seeing a couple of people that know me from social media here and it's really amazing to meet y'all. Like, it's really, really amazing. I'm going back inside to go fucking rave. Let's go, bitches.
Turn me inside out, make my heart beat. Leave no one else, you're all I need. Personality, everything you do, it's me love, everything about you. Your smile, your style, so fly, you can't deny.
So guys, I just got back. I'm so tired. I could literally fall into a coma. That is how tired I am. I have missed partying so badly that I literally danced. I just overdanced. That is all I'm going to say. I danced too much. And now it seems like... my entire body is going to give. Let me even put it in this color of light. If it's possible for me to just sleep and not wake up, I will. Lord knows, Lord in heaven knows that I am exhausted. This is the part of undressing I wasn't looking forward to. Taking out my contacts. I wasn't looking forward to this part. Like, I wanted to just fall on this bed, but I have to take out this contact.
So guys, today is the fourth day of the week And I literally started the day by ordering some food from Jumia. And my dispatch rider just got here, so I'm getting my food. I feel like 50% of this vlog has literally been me eating. And that is a very poor representation of myself. I don't eat that much. But for real, guys, I do not eat this much.
So, guys, I just want to get my order from Jumia Food. And I'm really so tired. Like, I'm still really, really tired. Honestly. Today is a Saturday, thank God. So, I don't have any major work. I'm actually going to be editing a video. Not this particular one, though. But I'm going to be editing a video today. My travel vlog to Lagos has to go up on my channel today. I started editing yesterday, so I'm just going to finish up today. So yesterday was really amazing, like really, really amazing. That space was queer friendly, it was queer accepting. It wasn't actually a queer party, but I met a lot of my friends, queer friends from, you know, social media. I met like people who are not even like my friends, but are obviously gay. And we were grinding up on each other. Nobody was batting an eyelid. You guys saw my friends, those two girls that were kissing literally on the dance floor. You know, I've been craving this kind of space where I can literally be myself. Look however I want to look, you know, dance however I want to dance. And that's why I don't go to the club, like, because it's a cis heterosexual space most of the time. And the moment you just start doing something outside of what they envision a boy should be doing, probably you start twerking or, you know, giving sass, everybody just starts looking at you some kind of way. But this space, this particular party I went to yesterday, it was amazing in every form. Also, this was my first time going to an alternative kind of party where the music wasn't necessarily Naija, it wasn't necessarily Afro, and it wasn't also hip-hop as well. It was alternative. It was just sounds, mostly just sounds and beats. Oh my God, it was so fucking good. So I know that Lagos has a thriving queer scene, which is like something I experienced yesterday. And that is just amazing. In fact, it's going to get gayer from here on out. It's going to get queerer because more parties I'm going to be attending would actually be queer parties organized for queer people. So it's about to be much, much rainbow-ish. So guys, I'm heading out again. It's Saturday, so I want to go see some of my friends. They invited me over to their house, and yeah, I just want to go have fun and chill this Saturday afternoon. So this is basically what I'm wearing. Let me just show you guys real quick. I have on this Chanel cap, which is fake obviously, and I have on a black crop top, right, and I have on a pair of blue mom's jeans and my boots, and then I have this kimono on. I'm gonna take this off when I get to my friend's place. So that's basically how I'm looking. My car is here already, so I have to start going. I'm going with this backpack because I need to take my laptop and do some work while I'm there. Hey guys, so I'm here, I've arrived at my friend's place. Should I show you guys a celebrity? There's a celebrity.
That's why I'm asking. Wear your shirt now. You guys, there's a celebrity in this house. Yes. Hi. So guys, this is Jua Jones, the one and only dancer that has danced for Chris Brown, Beyonce. Yeah, don't worry, we are getting there,
Sure. There's a come, let me shoot now, connect this thing.
Okay, where's Mawa? Is that Mawa?
Amina, say hi.
Hi.
See money. So I slept over at my friend's place, and at night we all saw the, you know, movie everybody's raving about, RRR. And basically this movie, it's a mouthful. I can't begin to tell you guys how many times my mouth was agape, open. Look at that arrow go. You guys, just look at the things happening. I didn't even know I was making these faces when I was watching this movie, because child, they went out of their way to test gravity, to test God in this movie, literally test God in this movie.
Yeah, I'm gonna end this vlog here. Thank you all for watching so far. I know this vlog was crazy as long, but also interesting, if I can say so myself. Don't forget to like and subscribe, guys. Yeah, show me some love and support. I literally put a lot into this work I do, and I would really appreciate your support. And not just liking and subscribing, also share. There are several ways you can share this video. You can screenshot, screen record, use the share button. Also, please do not forget to watch my ads. Please, I beg you guys, watch my ads. So ads are back on my channel. I know they were away or they were out of my channel for a couple of weeks, but they are back on the channel. Please, before watching my videos, do watch my ads. It's how I get paid. Also, in between my videos, there are some ads as well. Please watch them. I don't know why I always forget to do this. Most times it's when I'm editing that I remember, but we do something at the end of every video here on the channel. I will give you guys a word or a phrase or a hashtag, and you comment it down below so I know the people who actually got to the end of this vlog. Yes, I want to know you. I want to appreciate you. So if you got to the end of this vlog today, just go ahead and comment hashtag Pride 2022. Yes, today's one is going to be a hashtag, so go ahead and comment hashtag Pride 2022 and let me know you got to the end of this vlog. Have a wonderful one. Bye.